This is Ron from Super 8 to Video. In this video, I compare the Wolverine's digital zoom to the digital zoom in Video Studio Pro and Adobe Premiere Elements. This video here on the top left is the Wolverine Pro zoomed all the way out, in other words, W set to zero. This video on the right is the Wolverine Pro's zooming in, which is done digitally. This over here is zoomed in with the crop and scale, which is down here in Video Studio Pro under Distort Tools. This video over here on the right is zoomed in with the pan and zoom feature. I'm talking about this feature right here, video, pan, and zoom. In a well-lit scene like this, both this zoom and this zoom done through Video Studio Pro looks just as good as what the Wolverine machine does. This is exactly the same film as before, only what was pan and zoom over here has been swapped out by Video Studio Pro's competitor, Adobe Premiere Elements. As you can see, it does just as good a job. For the upcoming clip, instead of using this tiny little screen here to show you my settings, I am bringing it into the computer. This scene here is going to be much more tricky for the software because I'm going to zoom all the way in, plus I am copying at plus 0.5, which blows out the background here, makes it really brightly lit, but it allows us to see these people's faces up here. So we're going to zoom in to 24. All four films that will be played back when I am done with this will all be copied in plus 0.5 and zoomed all the way in. This will be the machine's version of zooming in. Adobe Premiere Elements will be the bottom right. The bottom left will be Video Studio Pro's crop and scale mode. Just as before, this is the machine zoomed all the way out. Over here is the machine zoomed in to 24, which is as much zoom as is possible with the machine. Over here is crop and scale, and over here is Adobe Premiere Elements version. If you look real close, you can tell this version here is a lot lighter. That is because the Wolverine Pro machine adds light as it zooms in. I think Adobe Premiere Elements added a little bit as well. This version here to me seems to be the closest to here out of all of them, the crop and scale mode. See how these people's faces here are more noticeable because the lighting went up with the Wolverine Pro, but the background is even more blown out. I'm going to show you what I mean by the machine added light to this. Instead of using the kids on the lawn, I am taking a very dark scene and zooming in because it becomes much more visible of what I mean by the machine adds light as you zoom in. See how it just added some light? Now a little bit more light. . 24 is as much as it'll go. So now you know what I mean by the machine adds light as it zooms in. So let's play this video. When I went to make this, I thought there would be bigger differences between the different zooms. As you can see, there is hardly any difference at all. I used the auto tone feature in Video Studio Pro to balance the film. So now it's showtime. to get the whole picture, including this, I cover the sprocket holes up with the text feature in Video Studio Pro. As you saw, there is very little difference between the different zooming methods. If you would like to learn how to get the whole picture and cover up the sprocket holes, click on the card now showing. This is Ron from Super 8 to Video, signing off.